So welcome you all for Tungal Online classes. So yesterday class we completed dual nature of matter and radiation. So I told you na part 2 is completely over. Just one chapter, that is communication system. So it will not be there in part 1. So one more chapter left, one small chapter which is of electromagnetic waves. So this chapter maximum weightage for subjective part of you, 2 to 3 marks. So we can expect 1-3 marks question, means 3 marks weightage of this chapter, electromagnetic waves. In this electromagnetic waves, starting one topic is there, which is based on displacement current. That concept of displacement current is deleted, so that's why I'm not discussing with that displacement current. Okay, Nara? So directly I will go with the first I will start source of electromagnetic waves. In this chapter we will discuss regarding electromagnetic waves, na electro EM wave, electromagnetic waves, and we will study regarding electromagnetic spectrum. So electromagnetic waves, what we will study? Production of electromagnetic waves. We'll study regarding nature of electromagnetic waves. What is the nature of electromagnetic waves? So then we'll study properties of electromagnetic waves. First topic, this one. And second topic we'll study regarding electromagnetic spectrum. Regarding this electromagnetic spectrum, you studied already what are the parts of the electromagnetic spectrum, that electromagnetic spectrum. And so there in this electromagnetic spectrum, that range you know. So what is the range of electromagnetic spectrum, what are the parts of electromagnetic spectrum, that we'll discuss. And their uses of electromagnetic waves and frequency range or wavelength range, or we'll study regarding wavelength range. Okay, Nara? These are the two parts we'll discuss under this chapter. So questions are frequently asking based on electromagnetic spectrum, especially uses. Many times they will ask, so what is the uses? You know that, na? So electromagnetic spectrum, what is the meaning of electromagnetic spectrum? The ordered collection of wavelength of electromagnetic waves called as electromagnetic spectrum. So what are the essential parts? There are 7 parts are there for this electromagnetic spectrum, which are given by radio waves. Next one is microwaves. Next we'll study regarding ultraviolet rays. First infrared rays. So infrared waves. So next one is visible light. So next one is fifth one, ultraviolet rays, UV rays. The next one is X-rays. The last one is gamma rays. So these are the 7 parts of electromagnetic spectrum. The main chapter is based on this electromagnetic spectrum only. We need to study their frequency range or wavelength range. Then we need to study their production, how to produce these, how to detect them, and what are their uses. Even for subjective point of view also, questions are asked, asking based on this electromagnetic spectrum only. Okay, na? So today class we'll see this part 1. So regarding the electromagnetic waves, production, nature and properties. And tomorrow class we'll study regarding that spectrum. So what is the
सोर्स ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक वेव्स, सोर्स ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक वेव्स. एक्चुअली हैव यू हियर्ड अ इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक वेव नेम? व्हाट इज इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक वेव? इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक वेव, वन एग्जाम्पल फॉर इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक वेव, सो लाइट, लाइट इज ए इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक वेव.
सो वॉट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक वेव? द वेव विच इंक्लूड बोथ इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड वैक्टर एंड ऑल्सो मैग्नेटिक फील्ड वैक्टर. द वेव विच इज प्रोड्यूस्ड ड्यू टू ए साइनसॉइडल वेरिएशन ऑफ बोथ इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड एंड मैग्नेटिक फील्ड. In a space, if the electric field and magnetic field both are varying alternatively, so both are varying simultaneously, not alternatively, both are varying simultaneously. So because of that, a wave will be generated. That wave is an electromagnetic wave. So actually, what is the source of this electromagnetic wave? So generally, charge is the source of any wave. So charge which is at rest, charge which is at rest. So produces only electric field, which produces only which field? Electric field. So whereas if the charge moving with a uniform velocity, charge moving with a uniform velocity. Uniform velocity means zero acceleration. If the charge which is moving with a uniform velocity produces both electric field. Both electric and magnetic fields, electric and magnetic fields. Okay, now, so whenever the charge which is accelerating, the accelerating charge, so accelerating charge, accelerating means so moving with the accelerating charge produces electromagnetic waves. A charge which is either oscillating or accelerating, so that charge can produce which one? Electromagnetic waves. So what is the source of electromagnetic wave? An accelerating or oscillating, I can also call accelerating or oscillating charge. So oscillating charge, a charge which is oscillating can produce electromagnetic wave. The frequency of that electromagnetic wave will be equal to, so frequency of oscillation of the charge. A charge which is oscillating will produce electromagnetic waves. So okay, now, so where we have seen in LC oscillator, LC oscillator, have we discussed it now? In which chapter? So alternate, in AC current chapter. In AC current chapter, what we'll do? So we'll connect a capacitor across a inductor, a charged capacitor connected across the inductor. Then what happened? So charge will be oscillating. Because of the oscillation of the charge, an electromagnetic wave can be produced. Electromagnetic wave can be produced. So that LC oscillator is the one of the source for so producing this electromagnetic wave. But in order to produce, for example, if I want to see a charge is oscillating, if I want to see yellow color light, so yellow color light frequency range is order of 10 power 14 hertz. So yellow color light will come under, so there are in waveguide colors will be there. If I want to produce a electromagnetic wave of yellow color, so we needed a frequency of 10 power 14 hertz. But till now, what are the operators are there? So using that operator, we can accelerate the charge up to a frequency, so 10 power 11 hertz. So that's why it is very difficult for experimental so detection of electromagnetic waves. But electromagnetic waves experimentally detected by the scientist Hertz. So experimental detection of, so experimental detection of electromagnetic waves. Done by the scientist Hertz in the year, so 1891, the experimental detection of electromagnetic waves was given by the scientist Hertz. One more question, so many time asked. So after that, many scientists came, even some Indian scientists also, they contributed for studying regarding this electromagnetic waves of small wavelength range. So later, some more scientists, so they have made arrangement for transferring this electromagnetic waves for several kilometers of distance. Electromagnetic waves to produce, charge has to be oscillate or it has to be accelerate. Now we'll get one doubt. For example, in a nucleus, so around the nucleus, electron is revolving. So does that electron revolving means it is moving in a circular path? It is nothing but oscillating or accelerating. When it is moving in a circular path, velocity changing. Velocity changing means acceleration will be there. So because of this, so is there any electromagnetic wave will be there? No. Electromagnetic wave to be observed, so we needed a large scale of oscillations. That frequency of oscillation should be greater, that is order of 10 power 14 hertz. So then only we can observe this electromagnetic waves. So only here you will get what is the source of electromagnetic wave. An accelerating charge produces electromagnetic wave. And who detected this electromagnetic waves experimentally? So by the scientist Hertz. So this electromagnetic wave, after coming to the know regarding the source, so next point is, what is the nature of electromagnetic waves? Now light waves, what we are using, that is electromagnetic waves only. Nowadays the communication system, so how it can be done that much fastly means our electrical signals will be converted into electromagnetic waves. In this electromagnetic waves, what will be there? A time varying electric field produces magnetic field. Produces which field? Magnetic field. And which in turn a time varying magnetic field. A time varying which field? Magnetic field produces electric field. So here, because of sinusoidal oscillation of both electric field and magnetic field, what is a wave generated? That is of electromagnetic wave. So electromagnetic wave produce agbekandre, you needed both electric field and also magnetic field. So because of the time varying electric field, magnetic field should be produced. Because of the time varying magnetic field, electric field should be produced. Actually we discuss, so whenever a current is passing through a conductor, around that conductor there exists magnetic field. Similarly, when there is a magnetic field around that, so conductor, so current, electric field also will be there. So that electric field we can calculate by using Maxwell's equation. So that Maxwell's equation will give us the explanation for the displacement current. So regarding the displacement current, we have not seen. The displacement current is because of time varying magnetic field produces electric field. Because of the magnetic effect of electric current, you know, so whenever current is passing through a conductor, a time varying electric field produces the magnetic field, you know. So the converse of this effect is the time varying magnetic field also produces electric field. So because of the simultaneous variation of both electric field and magnetic field, what is the wave generated? That wave is called as electromagnetic wave. So okay Nara. So and nature of this electromagnetic wave. So nature of electromagnetic wave. Electromagnetic wave is transverse wave in nature. In this electromagnetic wave, so what will be there? Both time varying electric field will be there and magnetic field will be there. If I call, so this is the electric field along x-axis. A time varying electric field can be represented by, so Ex value will be equal to E naught into, for example here, so this field is varying with respect to both space and time. So can I write E naught into sine kz, k into z minus omega into t. So this is the time varying electric field here. So if and one more is a time varying magnetic field. So this is the time varying magnetic field. So this magnetic field along y axis, so this is given by Bx. So what can I write? The value of Bx is given by Bx is equal to B naught into, so sine of k into z minus omega t. So because of this time varying electric field and magnetic field, the electromagnetic wave will be there, that will be propagating along. So if I call So time varying electric field and magnetic field both are there now. So three mutually perpendicular axis I need to consider. So this is for one axis. So let me call this is for x axis and this is for y axis and this is for z axis. If the electric field is varying along x axis and magnetic field is varying along so y axis, so then what happen? So electromagnetic wave will propagate along z axis. In a electromagnetic wave, electric field vector and magnetic field vector will vibrate both, so mutually perpendicular to each other. Their vibration will be perpendicular to the so direction of the propagation of electromagnetic wave. So velocity of electromagnetic wave is v, that is along z axis. So the time varying electric field represented by this, magnetic field represented by this, where E naught and B naught are called as so amplitude of electric field and magnetic field. So there is a relation is there between the time electric field and magnetic field. So that is C value given by E naught divided by B naught. So amplitude of electric field and magnetic field both are interrelated by the relation. So C is equal to E naught by B naught. So here K called as what? Propagation constant. So propagation constant, this K will give you the direction of the propagation of electromagnetic wave. So propagation constant, the value of this propagation constant K will be equal to 2 pi by lambda. So there is a relation is there, so that is the velocity of electromagnetic wave. So velocity of electromagnetic wave is given by so V is equal to omega divided by K. Omega value will be equal to 2 pi f and K value will be equal to 2 pi by lambda. So 2 pi cancel, we'll get the relation f into lambda. So wave velocity will be equal to omega divided by K. The propagation constant will give you the direction of the propagation of electromagnetic wave. In this given diagram, electromagnetic wave is propagating along z axis. So that's why, so K value will be given along z axis. Are you getting it? Electromagnetic wave produce agbekandre, electric field should vary with the time, magnetic field should vary with the time. A sinusoidal variation of electric field represented by this equation, a sinusoidal variation of magnetic field represented by this equation. So these both will vibrate perpendicular to each other in the direction of the propagation of electromagnetic wave. Wave is nothing but the form of energy. So how that energy will be propagated? In a direction perpendicular to so both electric field and also magnetic field. So this is, so finally the nature of electromagnetic wave is the transverse nature. Why it is transverse nature? Because the wave will be propagated perpendicular to, so particles of the medium vibrate perpendicular to wave propagation. That's why, so electromagnetic wave is which nature? Transverse wave in nature. So this is the nature of electromagnetic waves. After coming to know the nature of electromagnetic waves, so today class will start, we will discuss up to the properties of electromagnetic waves. The first important question for 3 marks, what are the properties of electromagnetic waves? What is the conclusion you should know? Generally, whenever if I made a charged particle, I have taken one charge now, I made this charge to oscillate. In order to oscillate, I needed some energy. So now, because of this, what happened? Now when the charge is oscillating, so what happened? Because of the charge, electric field will be produced. So now when the charge is oscillating, a time varying electric field will produce. That electric field produces magnetic field. Again, that magnetic field produces electric field. So what will be generated? An electromagnetic wave will be generated. So in that electromagnetic wave, what and what will be there? Both electric field will be there and magnetic field will be there. How both are mutually perpendicular? The frequency of that electromagnetic wave will be exactly equal to the frequency of oscillation of which charge. And the energy transferred by the electromagnetic wave will be equal to energy dissipated for oscillating this charge. Are you getting it? So that point you need to remember. Now let me know the properties of electromagnetic waves. Today I will conclude my class. So after telling these properties, what are the properties of electromagnetic waves? Electromagnetic waves properties. The first one is, so what is the first property? In electromagnetic wave, in electromagnetic wave, so both
इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड वेक्टर एंड मैग्नेटिक फील्ड वेक्टर वेक्टर वाइब्रेट परपेंडिकुलर टू ईच अदर एंड ऑल्सो परपेंडिकुलर टू डायरेक्शन ऑफ प्रोपगेशन ऑफ डायरेक्शन ऑफ प्रोपगेशन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक वेव्स. सो एवरी प्रॉपर्टी आई एम राइटिंग क्लियरली यू कैन कम टू नो इन इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक वेव इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड वेक्टर एंड मैग्नेटिक फील्ड वेक्टर विच आर वाइब्रेट परपेंडिकुलर टू ईच अदर एंड ऑल्सो परपेंडिकुलर टू सो डायरेक्शन ऑफ प्रोपगेशन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक वेव्स सेकेंड प्रॉपर्टी. सो दिस इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक वेव्स प्रोपगेशन फॉर द प्रोपगेशन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक वेव सो मीडियम इज नॉट रिक्वायर्ड इवन दे कैन ऑल्सो प्रोपगेट थ्रू वैक्यूम ऑल्सो मीडियम नॉट रिक्वायर्ड. सो दीज आर द नॉन मैकेनिकल वेव्स द सेकेंड प्रॉपर्टी मीडियम नॉट रिक्वायर्ड एंड द थर्ड प्रॉपर्टी इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक वेव्स in vacuum or free space free space travels with a speed so 3×10^8 meters per second and by the formula the speed of electromagnetic waves in vacuum is given by c is equal to 1/√(μ0)ε. If you want to calculate the speed, so we can show that c value will be equal to 1/√(μ0)ε. Are you getting it? Electromagnetic waves can travel with a speed. So 3×10^8 meters per second. This speed you can calculate by the formula 1/√(μ0)ε0. Whereas, the fourth one is, in a dielectric medium, the medium other than free space, dielectric medium, the speed of electromagnetic waves is less than 3×10^8 meters per second. They can travel with a velocity 3×10^8 meters per second only in free space or vacuum. If you take any other dielectric medium, the speed value less than 3×10^8 meters per second. So the speed of electromagnetic waves so depends upon the electric and magnetic properties of the medium. Magnetic properties of the medium. Actually, other than air or free space, so given by the formula, that formula is, so V is equal to 1/√(μ/ε). μ/ε. Okay, Nara? So still now I written 5 properties. First property, electric field vector, magnetic field vector, vibrate,
perpendicular to each other and perpendicular to the direction of propagation. Here, so the relation between the relation, here I can write one relation, C is equal to E naught divided by B naught. The relation between the amplitude of electric field vector and magnetic field vector is given by the relation C is equal to E naught by B naught. This formula is very important for doing numericals. The amplitude of electric field vector and magnetic field vector related by the formula C is equal to E naught by B naught. And the electromagnetic wave propagation medium not required. Electromagnetic waves travels with a velocity 3 into 10 to the power of 8 meters per second. In velocity, in free space, velocity formula C is equal to 1 by root over mu naught into epsilon naught, where mu naught is the permeability of the free space and epsilon naught is the permittivity of the medium, that free space. Whereas in any other dielectric medium, the speed of electromagnetic waves is less than 3 into 10 to the power of 8 meters per second. The speed of electromagnetic waves depends upon electric and magnetic properties of the medium is given by the formula V is equal to 1 by root over mu into epsilon. What is mu here? Permeability of the medium, and epsilon naught is the permittivity of the medium. So five properties are written. The question given for 3 marks means you can write any 3 properties. But let me discuss all properties. Okay, Nara? So after this, next one is sixth property. So what is the sixth property? In electromagnetic wave, electric field vector causes sensation of seeing. So seeing is because of sight, because of the electric field vector vibrations, so causes the sensation of seeing or sight, seeing or sensation of sight. So that's why electric field vector is called as light vector. Why? Because it only the causes the sensation of seeing. So that's why that vector is called as light vector. So seventh one is electromagnetic wave is transverse wave. Why it is transverse wave? Because here electromagnetic wave propagate perpendicular to particles of the medium vibrate perpendicular to wave propagation. That's why it is a transverse wave. So this is the property number 7. Next, 8th property. So generally electromagnetic wave will carry the vibration of electric field vector and the magnetic field vector. So in this property number 8th one, what I want to calculate is what is the average energy, density of electromagnetic wave. So this property is very important. I want to calculate average energy density of electromagnetic wave. Since electromagnetic wave will have electric field vector vibrations and magnetic field vector vibration. So due to that reason, the total energy of electromagnetic wave is due to electric field vector vibrations and magnetic field vector vibrations. So what is the energy density due to electric field vector vibration given by 1 by 2 into epsilon naught into ERMS square. If I write RMS value of electric field vector is ERMS, ERMS square. Similarly, what I will get the value of UB, 1 by 2 into which is mu no, 1 by 2 into BRMS whole square.
divided by mu naught. This already we discussed. This we discuss in electrostatics and this we discuss in magnetism and matter. So this is the energy density of electric field and this is the energy density of magnetic field. The total energy density will be sum of energy density due to electric field and energy density due to magnetic field. But there is a relation is there between C value will be equal to E naught by B naught, which can be also written as so E RMS divided by which one? B RMS. And there is one more relation is there for C. C value given by 1 by root over mu naught into epsilon naught. So can I take what is the value of UB? So UB value will be equal to UB value is equal to 1 by 2 into 1 by 2 mu naught into which one? B RMS whole square. So B RMS value can be written as 1 by 2 into mu naught into this value can I write E RMS whole square. So divided by C square. So once again, can I write the C square value 1 by root over mu naught into epsilon naught? What I will get the answer for UB? So UB value will be equal to which one? Which is mu into epsilon, mu naught into epsilon naught divided by 2 into mu naught into which one? So ERMS whole square. So from this, what can I write? UB value, here mu naught cancel. So 1 by 2 into epsilon naught into so ERMS whole square. What does it mean? So UB value will be equal to UE. So average energy density, that is UB and UE both are same. So what is the total energy density U value? So U value is UB plus UE, which can be also written as U value. So UB plus UB. Can I write? So then what I will get U value? So 2 into UB. So what I will get U value? So 2 into UB value. So B RMS whole square divided by which one? So 2 into mu naught. Then what I will get? 2 cancel. So what I will get the answer for U? U value will be equal to so B RMS whole square divided by which one? Mu naught. So which can be also written as U value will be equal to so E RMS. So epsilon naught into ERMS whole square. So this is the value of average energy density, the total average energy density of electromagnetic wave, which will be equal to so U is equal to which one? Epsilon naught into ERMS whole square, so which is equal to so which one? B RMS whole square divided by which one? Mu naught. But we know the value. ERMS value is equal to E naught by root 2. Similarly, so BRMS value is equal to B naught by root 2. This is the relation between RMS value and average value. So what can I write? The average energy density can be also written. So 1 by 2 into epsilon naught into so E naught square will be equal to 1 by 2 into so B naught square divided by 2 into B naught square divided by mu naught. Once you check this point, if I want to calculate the average energy density of electromagnetic wave, the total energy carried by the electromagnetic wave due to the vibration of electric field vector and magnetic field vector. The total energy of electromagnetic wave is the sum of energy of electric field vector vibration and magnetic field vector vibration. So what is the average energy density of electric field vector? Electric field energy density 1 by 2 into epsilon naught into ERMS whole square. Magnetic field energy density 1 by 2 into BRMS whole square by mu naught. So we know the relation. What are the relation? The relation between the amplitude of electric field and magnetic field. So C is equal to E naught by B naught, which is ERMS by BRMS. So C also can be written as 1 by root over mu naught into epsilon naught. Then what can I write? So UB value is equal to UE. UB is equal to UE means the energy density of electric field vector and magnetic field vector both are same. When both are same, so total energy density, this is the value of total energy. Total energy is the sum of electric field energy and magnetic field energy. But both are equal. I can write it as 2 into UB. When I write 2 into UB, 2 into, so what is the value of UB? UB value is 1 by 2 into BRMS whole square by mu naught. So 2 cancel, I got the answer U is equal to BRMS whole square by mu naught. Are you getting around? So similarly, so if I substitute here UE,
So UE plus UE, 2 UE. So 2 into UE value. So 1 by 2 into epsilon naught into ERMS whole square. That I will get. So U value epsilon naught into ERMS whole square. That means the total energy density of electromagnetic beam, the average energy density of electromagnetic beam is given by what? Epsilon naught into ERMS whole square, or which will be equal to, so BRMS whole square by mu naught. If they not given RMS values, if they given the peak values, the relation between the peak value and RMS value given by ERMS value is equal to E naught by root 2, BRMS value is equal to B naught by root 2. Then what happened to total energy density? The total energy density will be given by, so 1 by 2 into epsilon naught into E naught square, which will be equal to, so 1 by 2 into, so B naught square divided by mu naught. The finally, if you want to write the total energy density, so total energy density U is equal to 1 by 2 into epsilon naught into E naught square, which is equal to 1 by 2 into, so B naught square divided by mu naught, otherwise which can be also written as, so epsilon naught into ERMS whole square, which is equal to, so BRMS whole square by mu naught. So you can use any formula for calculating the energy density. In numericals, we'll come to know how to calculate the energy density. The total energy density of electromagnetic wave is the sum of energy density of electric field vector and energy density of magnetic field. So both are there. The total contribution of energy carried by the electromagnetic wave is the sum of energy due to the electric field vector vibration and energy so due to the magnetic field vector vibration. So this is the expression for average energy density of electromagnetic waves. Okay, Nara? So this is the property number 8th one. Next, 9th property. So what is the intensity of electromagnetic wave? The intensity of electromagnetic wave. Electromagnetic wave. So electromagnetic wave intensity will be equal to the total amount of energy transmitted per second per unit area. What is the total energy transmitted by the electromagnetic wave per second per unit area is called as intensity. So in order to derive the expression for intensity, let me consider one electromagnetic wave which is moving with a speed c. Which is moving with a speed c. Now let us imagine one cylinder of length c into delta t in a time t. That electromagnetic wave travels a distance c into delta t. Now to calculate the intensity, so let us consider one cylinder of length c into delta t and area value will be equal to E. Then if the average energy density will be equal to U average. So what is average energy density value? U average value will be equal to, so epsilon naught into ERMS whole square, which will be equal to, so BRMS whole square divided by, so mu naught. That is the average energy density. Now through this cylinder, if I want to calculate intensity, I want to know the total energy. What is the total energy transmitted? So through this, total energy value will be equal to average energy density into C into delta T into E. So what is the definition for intensity? It will be equal to U divided by, so A into time, here I will take delta T. So U value will be equal to U average into C into delta T into A divided by which one? A into delta T. Which one cancel? Delta T, A cancel. So what happened to intensity? Intensity value will be equal to average energy density divided into C. If you want to calculate the intensity of electromagnetic wave, the average energy density of electromagnetic wave will be multiplied with which one? Will be multiplied with C. So which will be equal to, what I will get? Epsilon naught into, so ERMS whole square into which one? C. Or which will be equal to, so BRMS whole square by mu naught into C. Okay, Nara, understood, Nara? What is the intensity of electromagnetic wave? Intensity means total amount of energy transmitted by electromagnetic wave per second per unit area. So to calculate the intensity, we know already what is the average energy transmitted by the electromagnetic wave, that I calculated. Now I imagine one cylinder of length C into delta T. The amount of average energy transmitted value is U average. Total energy transmitted in a given time. So that is average energy density. This is total energy density. Total energy density means so that is average energy density into volume. What is the volume of that cylinder? So length into area. What is the length value? C into delta T into E. Then I calculated intensity. So this is the expression for intensity of electromagnetic wave. These all formulas we needed for doing of numericals. This chapter numericals 5 marks will not be there, but 3 marks chance is there to ask. So then that is. So last point is 10th one. What is the momentum? The momentum of electromagnetic wave. Electromagnetic wave. The momentum of electromagnetic wave is given by the relation. So E is equal to, generally we know, H mu, and E is equal to mc square. Mc square value will be equal to H mu. Or E value can write, so mc square is equal to H mu. So M into C is equal to H mu, can be written as HC by lambda. So what can I able to write is H into, this is P. P is equal to HC by lambda, or directly I will write. So what is the momentum of electromagnetic wave? The momentum P value will be equal to, so here U divided by lambda. That is the, so expression for, otherwise we can able to write the total energy U ra. So U value will be equal to H mu, which is HC by lambda. So lambda can be written as, what is the formula for lambda, de Broglie wavelength? Lambda value will be equal to H by P. Then can I write, which is equal to H divided by H into C divided by H by P. HH cancel. So what I will get, U value. So U value will be equal to P into C. Then P value is equal to U divided by C. The momentum of electromagnetic wave, the total energy will be divided with C, that will give you momentum. Okay, Nara? So sometimes we need to calculate momentum. By calculating the momentum, we can calculate the force. What is the formula for force? According to Newton's second law, the force value F is equal to, so delta P by T. By using this formula, we can calculate the force. By calculating the force, we can calculate the pressure. What is the formula for the pressure? Pressure is nothing but force by area. So here force value delta P by delta T into E. So this is a formula for calculating the pressure. The pressure exerted by the electromagnetic waves is also called as radiation pressure. So that radiation pressure value, the scientist name, so visible light, normal visible light will exert a radiation pressure is of order, so 7 into 10 to the power of minus 6. So what is the units of radiation pressure? Newton by meter square. This is given by the scientists, so calculated by the in 1903 by Nicholas and Halvas, two scientists together, they calculated the radiation pressure exerted by normal light. That is the value 7 into 10 to the power of minus 6 Newton by meter square. Because of whenever this radiation incident on a metal surface or any surface, they will exert some momentum. That momentum value you want to calculate means the total energy divided with C. So by calculating U by C, you will get momentum. Whenever it is incident on total, so absorbing surface, momentum value will be equal to U by C. Whenever it is incident on total reflecting surface, the momentum value will be equal to 2 into U by C. Then after calculating momentum, force is equal to rate of change of momentum. So you can calculate the force by the formula delta P by T. When you know the force, you can calculate the pressure. Force by area, that pressure is called as a radiation pressure, which is delta P by delta T into E. So what is the radiation pressure for the normal visible light? This is 7 into 10 to the power of minus 6 Newton by meter square. Actually, what I discuss now properties, that question only for the 3 marks. If they given for 3 marks, any 4 or 5 points if you written, that is enough. But what I extra I discussed is that energy density and intensity and the momentum. So this calculation values what I required is so for doing numericals. So that's why I derived this. Otherwise the derivation not necessary. So only 5 to 6 properties if you remember, that is enough. So that's it for today class. So tomorrow we'll discuss regarding electromagnetic spectrum. Okay, Nara? Thank you.